24 HRS after ACES 10BA star viciously attacked white referee. Look who he was caught with, plan exposed. Fresh into a new season, the NBA had the opportunity to give Americans a sport they can watch without the politics but dropped the ball completely. Overpaid players in the league should have learned from the demise of the NFL, but apparently don't mind compromising the success of their league. However, they aren't just taking a knee for the national anthem. They are taking the racist, disrespectful antics much further than they, as we saw this weekend. Setting the sick tone for the season, Golden State Warriors' Stephen Curry attacked white referee seconds before his teammate, Kevin Durant, flipped off the crowd. The two of these entitled players were ejected from the game, and rightfully so. Now, 24 hours after that disgusting incident, Curry was caught sneaking around with the last person he should have been, in what appears to be a scamming session for what else this player can do to disrespect our country and the president. It's clear the Warriors aren't having a stellar season this year. In fact, they are downright starting to go the way of Kaepernick, which makes sense since Kaepernick and Curry are friends. However, that's not who Curry was seen palling around with today. He picked even worse company to hang with than that. Both Curry and Durant are spoiled, rich, entitled racists, proving that by Curry throwing his mouthpiece at the referee and Durant adding insult to the ref's injury by talking smack to him. Fans were less than pleased with the unsportsmanlike behavior and booed them off the court, who Durant flipped off, sending a clear message to those who had paid to support them. Curry needed some downtime after that game to relax and get his attitude back in check, but instead met with the one person who will probably make it worse. Curry was enjoying his day off with some the golf in Dallas and was joined by Barack Obama, who likely supported his courtside behavior the day prior. SFGate reports. Stephen Curry knows how to work off the sting of being ejected from a game, hanging out on the links with former President Barack Obama and golf star Jordan Spieth. Curry, Obama and Spieth were joined in Dallas by Under Armour CEO Kevin Plank, Jerry West's son Jae, who works for the Warriors organization, and Curry's brother Seth. As you can see from the photo of the group, everyone stayed very on brand for Under Armour. Obama was in Texas for the Deep from the Heart Hurricane benefit concert, and Steph Curry will be playing his brother's Mavericks on Monday night. Jordan hosted us at his course. Kevin Plank was able to get into town, and President Obama was here for a fundraiser with a bunch of other living presidents, Curry said. It was kind of the perfect storm of scheduling. Curry and Obama are semi-frequent golf partners. This was their third round together in 3 years. It makes complete sense that Curry and Obama are friends. They both share the same talent for destroying something great. Obama destroyed the country and Curry is on a path of destruction that will likely ruin the NBA, just like what we saw in the NFL. It's unknown what these two BFFs talked about in between swings, but among the typical competitive game banter the basketball player mentioned, there was probably a fair share of trashing their nemesis, Donald Trump, who also enjoys a round of golf. Beyond trash talking, the conversation on the links sounded more serious. When asked whether the Dallas group talked politics on Sunday, Curry said it was all we talked about. 3. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. Fresh into a new season, the NBA had the opportunity to give Americans a sport they can watch without the politics but dropped the ball completely. Overpaid players in the league should have learned from the demise of the NFL, but apparently don't mind compromising the success of their league. However, they aren't just taking a knee for the national anthem. They are taking the racist, disrespectful antics much further than they, as we saw this weekend. Setting the sick tone for the season, Golden State Warriors' Stephen Curry attacked white referee seconds before his teammate, Kevin Durant, flipped off the crowd. The two of these entitled players were ejected from the game, and rightfully so. Now, 24 hours after that disgusting incident, Curry was caught sneaking around with the last person he should have been, in what appears to be a scamming session for what else this player can do to disrespect our country and the president. It's clear the Warriors aren't having a stellar season this year. In fact, they are downright starting to go the way of Kaepernick, which makes sense since Kaepernick and Curry are friends. However, That's not who Curry was seen palling around with today. He picked even worse company to hang with than that. Both Curry and Doran are spoiled, rich, entitled racists, proving that by Curry throwing his mouthpiece at the referee and Durant adding insult to the ref's injury by talking smack to him. Fans were less than pleased with the unsportsmanlike behavior and booed them off the court, with Durant flipped off, sending a clear message to those who had paid to support them. Curry needed some downtime after that game to relax and get his attitude back in check, but instead met with the one person who will probably make it worse. Curry was enjoying his day off with some golf in Dallas and was joined by Barack Obama, who likely supported his courtside behavior the day prior. SF Gate reports. Stephen Curry knows how to work off the sting of being ejected from a game, hanging out on the links with former President Barack Obama and golf star Jordan Spieth. Curry, Obama and Spieth were joined in Dallas by Under Armour CEO Kevin Plank, Jerry West's son Jae, who works for the Warriors organization, and Curry's brother Seth. As you can see from the photo of the group, everyone stayed very on brand for Under Armour. Obama was in Texas for the Deep from the Heart Hurricane benefit concert, and Steph Curry will be playing his brother's Mavericks on Monday night. Jordan hosted us at his course. Kevin Plank was able to get into town, and President Obama was here for a fundraiser with a bunch of other living presidents, Curry said. It was kind of the perfect storm of scheduling. Curry and Obama are semi-frequent golf partners. This was their third round together in 3 years. It makes complete sense that Curry and Obama are friends. They both share the same talent for destroying something great. Obama destroyed the country and Curry is on a path of destruction that will likely ruin the NBA, just like what we saw in the NFL. It's unknown what these two BFFs talked about in between swings, but among the typical competitive game banter the basketball player mentioned, there was probably a fair share of trashing their nemesis, Donald Trump, who also enjoys a round of golf. Beyond trash talking, the conversation on the links sounded more serious. When asked whether the Dallas group talked politics on Sunday, Curry said it was all we talked about. Of course it was, because these two seem to be coming together as a band of brothers to promote protests in the NBA and make President Trump's leadership more difficult with the divisiveness and defiance of his will. Birds of a feather flock together, as we already have seen from Curry, who is working overtime to side with Colin Kaepernick any way he can. Although Steph Curry is a Carolina Panthers fan, he made his support known for has-been, unemployed 49er quarterback Colin Kaepernick during the 49ers vs. Panthers game. Curry posted an Instagram story during the game with the caption, #FreeCap. Last season, Colin Kaepernick, with the advice of his girlfriend who has deep ties to Islam, refused to stand for the national anthem as a show of a silent protest against police brutality, racial injustice, and inequality. Because we all know a contract of $120 million isn't enough to heal the inequality he feels. Although he's said multiple times that he would stand for the anthem if added to a roster this season, he's still yet to have been picked up by a team, leading some to speculate that he's been blackballed by NFL teams because of the negative attention he drew to himself last season. Of course, any of us who followed football know very well that the real cause for his unemployment is that he just isn't a good player.